continue to flow through us. I pray for my friend Tracy, that as she seeks to share her heart, that you'll flow through her to us. Transform in our minds the things she intends to say. Give her peace in her heart to speak freely and clearly. And may you be honored in all that we're doing. We love you so much. Amen.
Amen. So I have my security blanket right here. So I'm going to be like holding on to it. I'm really excited and nervous and like, I'm Tracy, by the way, if you didn't know. For guests, you know, who are here, I lead the Bridge Kids Ministry. I'm the director there. And yeah, okay, let's do this. So, okay. This is hard. Oh, okay. So, I used to think that because I was a follower of Jesus, I had accepted him into my heart, that he would fix me. He would take control of my life and heal the hurts of my past. Well, I found out that it's not that simple. For me, anyways. Mark spoke last week about voices in your head that tell you a different story than God's truth for you. This is an example of mine, what I've been saying to myself. He loves me. He loves me not. 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 A couple of weeks ago, I attended the Women of Faith Conference here in Portland. I was really excited and hopeful that God was going to show up. I needed him to show up. So I started praying and giving him access to this time, asking him to bring clarity to my unrest. Do you know the feeling in your soul when it's just spinning? You feel anxious and not clear of your direction? That has been me for the last few months, particularly here at Bridge City. I so much, on one hand, wanted to control in some way outcomes, to have influence, speak truth, hold people accountable. But on the other hand, wrestling with, what am I supposed to be doing? God, where do you want me to be? Give me a sign, show me the way. This Women of Faith conference was the first door of many that God opened to bring clarity to my unrest. One of the speakers there, Jenny Allen, has written a book called Anything. She shared with us this wonderful perspective. She said, "We are all chasing something. Our hearts were made to run hard and fast after things that move us. But as a generation, we are all beginning to stir and wake up and identify that these words don't satisfy for long, especially compared to God." The words I want to share with you are up here. I did it. She shared these words with us, and she wanted us to just take a look at them, see if they resonated with us in our spirit. Comfort, control, power, and approval. I was thinking to myself, I'm not sure which one resonates with me, and I told my mom, she was sitting next to me, I said, I kind of feel like mine's comfort, but I'm not sure. And so she had us do this exercise, and I would love for you guys to do this with me. I want you to close your eyes I'm going to read these voices. I'm going to read these words off to you. I'm going to turn around. This is between you and God. No one knows. No one's going to see them. But when I say these words, if one of them resonates with you, if this is, one of these words is something that you want in your life, I want you to raise your hand, okay? Comfort. Control. Power. Approval. Okay, you can put your hands down. I love to pray right now. Father God, just help me to be clear in what I'm saying today, Father. I just pray that if something that is speaking to our people here today at Bridge City, that they will hear what your truth is about it. That the words that I say are not just words. This is my experience, Father, but I just pray that you'll just want to give you access to them in this space. And be with us. In Jesus' name, amen. She said, these things that we chase are the very things that start to define our life. In Psalm 16:4, it reads, their sorrow shall be multiplied who choose another God. These false idols are pale in comparison to God and what he wants for us. Thank you, Frank, for that. She said, this is the time, and I believe the time is now, to acknowledge what God is saying to you. I left the conference that day praying like a madwoman in the car, speaking out loud, like, what is going on here? What am I supposed to be hearing? Giving God access to this awareness. Just cut to the chase, God. What am I supposed to be hearing? I don't know. Praying. Through that evening, went to bed, wrestling, like not sure what he was trying to speak to me. I woke up early Sunday morning with this overwhelming sense of his presence and peace in my heart. That I hadn't felt in a long time. It was wonderful and beautiful. In Psalm 16, 5 and 6, it says, Lord, you have assigned me my portion and my cup. You have made my lot secure. The boundary lines have fallen for me in pleasant places. This isn't pleasant, what I'm doing right here. Just wanted to just interject that. But the biggest thing is this is a privilege. When God speaks to you, we have to share it. And it doesn't necessarily have to be up on this stage. But it has to be with the people that we're around, the people that we touch. So I discovered something that day. I realized I had two idols that were separating me from God. You see, the first one has been in the shadows for a long time. His name is Comfort. For years, I've chose to eat when I'm happy, when I'm sad, when I'm angry, when I'm mad. My weight has fluctuated up and down. The guilt and the shame and the energy that has gone into the next plan has been so exhausting. It has taken me away from day at times. the loud voices in my head say, you're a failure. You don't have it in you to follow through this time. This dude named Comfort has been chasing, that I have been chasing, has taken me further and further away from God, myself, and my loved ones. That morning that I woke up on Sunday, he placed a gift in my heart. I had the knowledge of his power and his ability to transform and heal in my brain for years. But that morning, he placed that piece of that knowledge in my heart. In Psalm 16:11, it says, you make known to me the path of life. You fill me with joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand. He was holding on to my hand. Okay. I heard him say, just be still and know that I am God. You see, God has not been withholding anything from me. This idol that I have been chasing has stopped me from pursuing my dreams. Activities with my kids. Intimacy with my husband. Dave has been a slice of Jesus for me. He sees past that brokenness and pursues me like God does. I am so lucky and blessed to have people in my life who speak truth to me, who push into those tender places and love me unconditionally. But all that is discounted when I can't receive it, when I don't believe it. The second idol I've been chasing for the last few months has been control. God's taking care of it. I'm not holding on to that. I gave him access. He has brought clarity to the control that I was trying to do here. He has brought hope and forward movement. It's not about me. It's not about what I can do. It's how I show up. Is God speaking to me? What am I supposed to be doing? What path am I supposed to be on? What does he want me to do? When I decided to follow Jesus, I didn't have all the tools to keep the enemy away. But over the years, he has placed believers and non-believers to stand in the gap with me. They have believed in me when I didn't. I was choosing to let my brokenness get in the way of living life abundantly. I believed at times I was not worthy of God's love. But that was a lie. That's a total lie. God sacrificed his son for me. And on that day, everything was stripped away. When I chose to follow God, all of my sins and my past hurts were taken. With that, he is the one that can transform me if I give him access. In Hebrews 10:22 and 23, it says, "Let us draw near to you, God, with a sincere heart and with a full assurance that what faith brings, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience, and having our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold unwavering to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful." God has been with me the whole time. He has had his hand on me the whole time. That morning, it was very clear to me. And I believed it. He said, "I am the only comfort you need. Let me control your path. I have the power to transform your life if you let me." You don't need approval from man or woman. I got this. So now, I have a new saying. It's, "He loves me. He loves me. He loves me. He loves me. He loves me." I believe it now. I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful for this opportunity. Listen.
I'd like you to sing with us. Thank you.